Mga ka-nation, today on Lasang Pinoy, we are featuring a different type of high-end cuisine. Kaya tamang-tama lang ang ating tama ngayon. Joining me on Lasang Pinoy is Chef Flip Fantabulous, aka Rudy Santa Ana. He is joined by his cousin Walter Santa Ana. Together, they founded Cannabis Catered Events. And also, I would like to introduce your sous chef, Chef Dave Rogers, aka Danky Dave. Gentlemen, I have to officially welcome you to Adobo Nation with a hi.
Thank you.
Thanks for having
me here.
All right, great with the cheesy jokes. All right, guys, thank you for coming in, and Happy New Year, of course. I want to start things off with something very general, you know, hopefully for our viewers and for myself as well. School us, give us a general understanding of what cannabis is and what it's made, you know, what its ingredients are.
Well, you're really dealing with two active ingredients in cannabis, and that's CBD and THC. My company tends to focus more on the CBD aspect of the food, which is more of a medicinal way of taking cannabis.
We hear that all the time, Chef Rudy. So there's the THC part and the CBD part. The biggest difference between them is what exactly?
Well, THC is more of the psychoactive element of cannabis, and that's what gets you high, per se, or the closest thing I could, you know, say is maybe feeling drunk or something like that. And CBD, you don't feel like that at all. CBD is more for your body to address anxiety, help you sleep, and just kind of relax you and get you through your day. So you can take CBD in high dosages and not feel high. Most people are taking about 5 to 10 milligrams of CBD drops a day just to kind of get them, you know, give them the energy, give them the things that they need.
You know what I mean?
Basically, it's their vitamin of the day, you know, and not take away all their pharmaceutical pills. And if not all, at least most of them, a majority of them, you know. So blood pressure, Ambien, anxiety pills and stuff like that.
There's a lot. There's a whole long
there's
list.
There's a long
list. Anti-inflammatory, antioxidants.
That's right. That's right. I know there's a long list of medicinal purpose for cannabis. But you mentioned it. You guys mentioned it. Really, when it comes to the cuisine, it really focuses on CBD. So it's really not stuff that, you know, you're going to walk away from super high, right? Or high at all, even.
High at all, even. So unless my client requests for THC to be infused into the food that I make, I really don't, it's not a component that I'm adding because I'm like I said, I really focus more on CBD and the medicinal elements of cannabis, you know, not just recreational, really.
Okay.
So although I do some events that are recreational, but that's what I'm hired to do. So most of my clientele focus on medicine.
You know, and I want to quickly make sure that we go get through all of the food because there is some delicious food that is in front of us here. And then maybe you can also, in the process, tell us about cannabis infused versus cannabis pairing. And I want to go ahead and welcome the other gentlemen to chime in as well. But Chef Rudy, go get things started and tell us what you guys brought in today.
Well, I kind of brought in the dishes that I do at my events. It's kind of like what I'm known for. So over here, we'll start to your left. I have a vegan enoki mushroom salad, right? And it's pickled. It's close to a Thai cucumber salad. And this is one of my vegan dishes, and it's very low dose on CBD, about 5 milligrams. So I like to get people through the meal that they consume maybe like 15 to 20 milligrams of CBD or THC throughout the whole entire meal.
So it's not anything that, you know, I'm sure that's a big misconception when people hear cannabis infused. You know, they don't realize that maybe one, doesn't have to be infused with anything at all. Two, you could pair it with cannabis, right? And you can walk away really not feeling any sort of psychoactive effects.
And the next dish I'll get to is my adobo tacos over here on Adobo Nation. So this dish, I pair it usually. So it's not infused usually at my stations, and then I pair it maybe with like some CBD drinks or a CBD vape or cartridge or something like that.
Quickly explain to us what that pairing means.
So the pairing would be that, think of it like a wine pairing, how you would pair your food with wine. So it's the same exact thing, but instead of wine, you use cannabis, you know? And so I tend to focus on CBD, like I said, but there's some events that I do have, like some THC flower, like what they would say is marijuana, you know?
I see.
But not in the food, but just paired to smoke it with before you eat it.
Okay.
Kind of.
All right.
So it's like you would drink
and
wine.
It enhances the flavor, kind of draws out different aspects of the food, right? I'm sure.
And
it
enhances your mood as well while you eat.
While you eat.
Right.
And I'm sure,
just like wine does.
Chef Dave and Walter, I'm sure you guys have your favorites here from among the table.
Oh, definitely.
We've got a couple dishes left. Do you have a particular favorite? And you guys can kind of tell us about it as well.
Definitely. I think the Bicol Express is one of our best. And then, of course, the chicken adobo. All of them are really, really good. And it just depends on how you want it. If you want it a little bit spicy, salty, sugary, we all have it here for you
guys.
And
if you want to blow your mind, go and eat the Elota pizza right here.
You got to tell me about this because it is topped with my favorite topping, which is.
So this is Mexican street corn, and I put it on a pizza and topped it with hot Cheetos.
That sounds delicious.
It's
cannabis
really
or
simple.
Not, that's mine.
It's vegetarian, no meat. You know what I mean? So. That's another reason that people enjoy that. That's one of my hot hitters, you know, at events that I do. Mm-hmm. This right here is my signature dish, which is a Thai, Vietnamese, and Filipino fusion.
Wow.
So I got the Vietnamese vermicelli noodles, the tom yum sauce from Thai food, and then this is a pork beef steak.
Oh my goodness.
Which is a pork steak, you know, that I braise on top, and I just, you know, top it with some veggies, and that's like my most famous dish.
What's this called again, Chef Rudy?
I really don't have a name for it yet. I just call it my tom yum braised pork.
Really darn good tom yum braised pork.
So,
and of course, did we go through and say what this is?
Actually, we haven't. This is a new dish that I'm going to introduce in 2019 to my followers. And this is a street food in the Philippines that after a night of drinking, this is home. Mm-hmm. Beef patis, you know?
Ooh.
So it's like I'm going to introduce it to my followers and all the people that attend my events, and it's going to be my new bite at my next event.
All right. So. And last but not least, this is, we're ringing in the new year with the beef patties, but last but not least, we want to go with poduil. Tell us about the poduil that you have with us.
Or I like to call it PDH. It's infused olive oil. They're my sponsor, and they're out here in San Francisco, by the way. And the small bottles are 25 milligrams. It's a really easy way to microdose the meal, right? And just add some, that component that you need, you know, to help you feel better in your food. So the thinking behind it is you want your food to heal you, you know what I mean? And make you feel better. So it's like, that's what I really try to focus on.
All right, I'm definitely going in for the beef patties, ringing in 2019 with a bang. Chef Rudy, let's go through the details, make sure that our nation know how to get in touch with you guys.
Yeah, definitely. Please come check me out on Instagram at Cannabis Catered Events. I also have a personal Instagram, which is FlipFantabulous, and CannabisCateredEvents.com.
Yes, exactly. CannabisCatered.com. Also follow me at MainSource777 for any events that we may put together for you guys in the upcoming year. Mm-hmm.
And you can find me at The Danked Out Chef on Instagram. I'm located in Vallejo, California, so I'm here local in Bay Area. And I'm ready to party. Let's do this.
I'm happy. We'll be seeing much more of you guys. And again, you can have it infused or not yet. So I'm going to have the one that's not infused.
Happy New Year, guys.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, guys. Maraming salamat. We'll be seeing you guys again.